Good evening. Now, they are having youth up there, if anybody wants to go up there. I want to talk tonight to the little ones that would be going to class. I've already had several come in and didn't know, so I do want to let you know that that is going on up there. All my little ones that would go to a class tonight, if there was one available, come up here to the front. All the little ones that'll come up here and sit down. If we have to, we'll make Brown scoot back a row, but come up here. Or y'all come over here. That'll be good. Yeah, y'all move right over here. Everybody go this way. Pile on. It's just long way around. Come on in. You come over here, you sit right there, don't mind. Wherever you'll come. Here you go. How's everybody doing tonight? How many of you remember a message on a pin? Well, these kids in about 5 weeks are going to be able to take a pin. They're going to be able to give anybody they need to the gospel. If they don't have a Bible, if they've got this pin, don't need it. Anybody else want one or need one? I've got some more. I've got a bag full of them. If you got one in your pocket, you're welcome to get it out. And the book of Luke, chapter number 20, verse number 24. I hope everybody's listening here. This place is going to move around. The teachers know that. And we're going to buy them up in the age. They're two different in age. We'll have everybody be with their own age eventually, because some's a little older and some's a little younger. But the book of Luke says, show me a pin. Hold your pin up. Now turn your pin on heads.
Heads?
What's a heads? Some of you. Can't read it yet. You see what I'm doing? Luke 20:24 says, show me a pin.
No.
I was standing on the ball field. Any of y'all play ball or want to play ball? I stand on the ball field one time and an umpire walks up to me. Goes in 1 minute, he gave me a whole message. I just got saved. He said, you're going to be a preacher, right? And I said, maybe. And he said, let me give you a message. And I've shared this all over the place. People got saved. God has really used it, but I'm only going to give y'all one point tonight, about 10 minutes. How many of y'all can listen for 10 minutes? How many of y'all can listen for 10 minutes? But he told me this. The front of the penny says, in God we trust. On the top. In God we trust. Then, it's got a date, and that's the year that penny was made. But we're going to use that as the date. I can use it as the day I got saved. One of these days, you're going to come to the age of accountability. That's when you know sin from not sin. Not right from wrong, but the difference in sin. And you will have that day one of these days. And then you'll have liberty, and that's freedom. Now, if we let them have freedom tonight and said, go like you want to go, they'd tear this place apart in just a minute, right? Songbooks, lines, everything else. Then turn your penny over, and I'll give you a point here in a minute, we'll be done. She's smiling at me. United States of America. You're united. This is a group. You see this group behind you, all these old people? See all these old people behind you? That's called the church. That's the church, but what makes them the church is not the building that they're in. But all these folks that are saved, they're one body, and y'all will be one body. And then it's because of one sin. It says one sin. See that? That's because of one sin. Who was one sin? Does anybody died on the cross for our sins, didn't he? Very good. So let's look back at the head of the penny, and I'll give you what I want to give you tonight. We're going to learn about a word, and then we'll be done. In God we trust. I'm going to talk to you tonight just a few minutes on the word trust. Who knows what the word trust means? What's it mean? Somebody tell me. What do you think trust means? Throw it out there. It don't matter.
Believing.
Good. What do you think, Kim? Who do you trust? Trust your friends sometimes?
Yeah, not all the time.
Not all the time. Right. This is why we're out here. He's way ahead of the game. That's right. Not all the time. But trust also means confidence. And I look the word trust up, and it's somebody that you can count on, somebody that has your best interest in mind. Somebody that loves you, that wants the best for you. So that would be your mom, your dad, your family, God. How many of you know how to trust God? Why was he able to get up there and just fall back? Why'd you do that? Because you trust me. Because you knew what? I'd catch you. So come here, man. You trust me? Trust is, it's not physical. It's not that you can catch somebody, but it's trusting God in every part of your life. See, when you got saved, Cohen just got saved here recently in baptized. And when he got saved, it wasn't a physical trust. He trusted God because if he asked him, that he would save him. And he loves you all so much that you got somebody. See, one of these days, your mom and dad, they won't be there. They're there all the time now. But you're going to get older, bigger, and you're going to have somebody that you can trust. And it'll be God. And when you take somebody this penny, and you got this penny in your pocket, and you want to talk to them, you don't know what to say, you say, see this penny? And God, we trust. That's number one. So what are we talking about tonight?
God.
Jason? Yeah. He can catch us all one time, good. But Kimmy couldn't catch Jason, but she loves him.
He can catch
everything. That's right. See, all of us are going to go through stuff in life, but we're going to have to trust God. The things that we can't catch with our hands, things we can't feel, and things we can't change, but we've got to trust him that he's here and he's with us. Y'all believe that?
Yes.
See, y'all are young and little. God. take this little penny right here, though. Sister, you can take it and teach a class on all these things for 2 months. And if we can have these kids just take a penny and keep it in their pocket, then they got a Bible with them all the time. There's a verse for every part of that. And trust is the first key, because if you don't trust it, it won't work. You don't trust it, you're afraid to fall, right? What do y'all want to do now? Try to church bar? She usually got another song from Jesus. You ready? Say whatever you want to. But I think it's important that the church get behind this age kids, because on a regular service, we're going to have 3 rows of these kids. Man. We're going to have 3 rows. We're going to have a classroom full of this size, about 2 classrooms full of this size. You know how blessed we are? Right here, look. Right here's more kids than most churches have in Cleveland tonight. What we learned about tonight? One word. God and
trust.
And a penny. And trust.
Trust.
That's right. If anybody here comes saying God and penny, or God and Jesus, we're doing good, right? Or the one sinner. And I can't wait. I might teach that lesson myself. Everybody stand up. We're going to sing. Big people, Bible says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not on your own understanding. Acknowledge Him in all thy ways; He'll direct your paths. And also says, oh, taste and see the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in Him. So you can't go wrong trusting in the Lord. And I feel like it's easy for these kids to fall backwards into our hands because they know we're there. They can feel us. They can see us. But it's hard for us, right, to trust Him and know everything's going to be all right, to know that Romans 8:28 is the truth, to know that the Bible's real all the time. We buried a 28-year-old woman today. Guarantee her family's having a hard time trusting in the Lord right now. We got something precious here at Cornerstone. We need to pray. Help me pray on how to do these little classes. If we need to keep little boys together and little girls together, if we need to put them all together, what we need to do. I want to do it exactly right, pleasing to the Lord. I want to be as close as I can get to what He wants, Brown. It's a big deal. But I love these kids. We got some good ones. We got some good ones. Up here's full too tonight. More people up here than there are in most churches too. James is up there letting them have it right now, I guarantee you. They're hearing something good tonight, Miss Reba. They're hearing something good. Y'all want fellowship? Tell one of these kids you love them. Let's get behind them. Help them. Yeah, still a strange time out there. Still a strange time. Love on one another. Fellowship. Amen. It's good to have that date on the penny, ain't it?
Yep.
Amen. Fellowship, love on one another, and liberty to get when you get ready.